I'm lucky to be joined by Dr. Joseph Chen. We are kicking off CI 2016.
Exciting times. How are you feeling?
Gina, thank you for having me. We are indeed very, very excited.
What can people expect from this year's conference?
Well, I think a lot of people will come from different walks of healthcare life. Mm-hmm. All the stakeholders, meaning the clinicians, the scientists, the surgeons, auditory verbal therapists, the audiologists. In fact, there are some patients probably in the audience. They will all leave with something different, I think.
And from your perspective, why is it so important to bring people all together to chat about this sort of thing?
You know, it's important to have a common theme. And this year's theme is about the brain's impact on the outcome. And that is we call auditory plasticity. And this is a real hot topic in the literature. So I think it's important to have a theme for every conference. And this year's conference is exactly about that.
So what are the major issues or concerns that you think will be discussed at this year's conference?
Aging is a new hot topic. Early development and rehabilitation is another hot topic. Musicality, to be able to use a cochlear implant and to interpret sound accurately, to be able to hear musical notes accurately, to enjoy music listening, to be able to play an instrument again for these patients is really a godsend. It's really truly a miracle for a lot of these patients.
Now, how about children as they get closer to adulthood? What are some things that they need to consider with hearing implants?
Well, this is an excellent question, and it's actually a very challenging issue that we face currently. Wearing my hat as the provincial coordinator of the Ontario Cochlear Implant Program, we have to make provision for care in terms of graduates of a pediatric program moving into an adult center. And this is particularly important in large centers like Toronto. With regards to pediatric patients, the current standard of practice is bilateral cochlear implantation. That is, put one implant in each deafened ear. So patients are wearing two implants. And of course, this has a lot of advantages in terms of learning and acquisition of language. But it also drives up the cost of the care. We have to think of a strategy whether one side will be implanted or both sides will have to be implanted. So that will continue to be a conversation that we will have within Ontario, within all the Ontario centers, as to how to look after pediatric graduates and how they are different from adults, because adults in Ontario currently receive one cochlear implant. So I think the most challenging part for the Canadian system is access to care in terms of wait time. Wait time is probably highest in the most populous cities and provinces like Ontario, mm-hmm. Quebec, and British Columbia. And wait time can be as long as 2 years for service. So provision of care is the biggest challenge that we have in Canada. Over the last 30 years, cochlear implant technology has grown to the extent that it has outperformed our expectations. And that is something really amazing to see. It is arguably one of the most important innovations that we do. Kids learn not just one, sometimes two, three languages after they have received a cochlear implant. What we have learned is that the brain has the capacity to make up for technology that wasn't there back then, and using the technology today, we can really achieve really significant gains and wonderful performance.
Well, it's incredibly inspiring work. I can't wait to hear more in the days to come. Best of luck at CI 2016. Thank you for joining us.
Thank you very much, Gina.